My brother, it's the same like what you just said there. Either you're being insincere, that's a whole sentence. Do you want me to take just one, two words out of it? But you just said a whole sentence. John said a whole sentence. In the beginning, was the word. The word was with God. The word was God. The word became flesh and lived amongst us.
No problem.
That's Jesus Christ.
No problem. I accept that. So now let me question it. Now let me question it. Right. So in the beginning was the word. Right.
Which word? What's that? What word?
The word of God.
Well, hold on. So in the beginning was the word.
In his fire is written the word of God.
So before the word was God, right? In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God. Like, what's your name?
Jersey.
Right. So Hamza is Hamza. So my Hamza is with Jersey. Are we two separate entities?
Yes, two persons. Yeah. So we don't deny
right,
that. No,
right, good. So that means in the beginning there wasn't one God. There were two gods.
No, it's not saying two
listen,
gods.
Listen, listen.
No, you're putting not, that into it.
I'm not saying.
You are applying that to the sentence.
That's what the sentence means,
your
though.
Your human brain is applying that.
Am I saying something that doesn't make sense?
No. That's what literally the sentence means.
So your 1 kilo brain is going to understand the eternal God of the universe that created time, space and matter and every molecule and all your coded DNA.
Look.
Your 1 kilo brain is going to understand that.
Do you know who Melchizedek is?
Melchizedek, yes I do.
Who is Melchizedek?
He was a priest back in the time of Abraham that he had, it says he had no beginning. But that's not.
Is he God?
It had no beginning of fathers and mothers. They had no records for him.
Didn't say that.
It had no records.
Where does it say that it's about records?
It's about records. They had no records for him.
Show me.
Will you show me where it says he's God then?
No, but hold on a minute. Wait, you're
skipping.
Jumping.
You're skipping.
You're jumping to say it's eternal.
Show
me where it says
you
it's
have
eternal.
You've enforced interpretation.
So you said he's eternal.
I never said he's eternal.
What did you say?
I'm saying to you, are you actually listening?
He just asked you who Melchizedek is.
I asked you who Melchizedek is. You said he's a priest of the Most High.
He was a God. He was a king and priest.
Now I asked you,
king and priest.
The Bible says that he has no beginning, no ending of life, no ending of days.
Right.
You said this is talking about what?
Mother and father.
There's no genealogy for the guy.
Right. So where does it say that? That there's no genealogy. So you're
because
putting,
there's not none there.
No, show me. Show me.
There's none
show
there
me
to
that's
show
what
you.
He's talking about.
No, but there's none there to show you.
That
genealogy.
Is what he's talking about.
But there's no genealogy show to show you.
So you know what that shows?
What does that
right?
show?
It shows that
your lack of understanding of who Melchizedek
actually,
is.
No, actually,
no, is you're adding to
Abraham,
the...
Because Abraham met him.
I'm saying to you...
Abraham met him, right? And he was just a king, a normal king, priest,
does he
right?
Does he have a beginning of days?
He had no record of beginning of days.
Yeah, but you're just adding that.
Where Abraham had a father.
I'm going to get the verse
Jesus
up.
Had
and
a genealogy.
I want
genealogy.
You to show me where...
Matthew said, had a genealogy. They all had... Right?
I want
this
you to
guy
show
didn't
me,
have no genealogy.
I want you to show me where it's speaking about his record of
so
his,
where is he
and
now?
His genealogy.
Where's Melchizedek? Now, if he's got no end or no beginning.
No, I'm not,
where is he now?
I don't know.
Right, so you've got to understand what scholars
brother,
say,
just
right?
Help me with this one,
listen, bro, the scholars say that there's no record for Melchizedek, right?
Thanks,
so he's no beginning. That's why I say there's no record. He was just a king priest
you know
at the time.
You know what it is? Unfortunately, so I can't say this.
From the word, in the beginning of the word, Melchizedek.
And I'll tell you why. Because you are an actual polytheist.
You're a polytheist, yeah. You believe in more
one
than
God.
No, you don't.
One God.
You believe in more than one God.
No, one God.
You believe that
in the beginning was the Word.
Okay.
The Word was with God.
Is the Father equal to the Son?
They're both co-equal.
Right. So in the and the Holy Spirit is equal with
God. Co-equal. They're all one
right.
God.
So how comes the Holy Spirit didn't know that the day of judgment?
How come that? Because he emptied himself.
No, he emptied himself. I said the Holy Spirit. I never said the Son. How come the Holy Spirit did not know the day of judgment? If the Holy Spirit is God and equal with the Father.
Where does it say Holy Spirit do not?
Jesus said on that day, on that hour, knows no man. He said,
no man.
The Son.
Man.
Only the Father knows.
Listen, he said, only the Father knows.
And what's the Spirit of the Father? Well, who is the Spirit of the Father?
Am I speaking English to you?
Who is the Spirit of the Father?
Look, you said there's three of
the Holy
them, yeah?
Spirit. Right. So does the Holy Spirit know the hour?
The Holy Spirit.
Does the Holy Spirit know the hour, yes or no? He said the only one who knows the hour is the Father. So
the Father. So is the Father spiritless?
You know what, if you're playing games.
Is the Father spiritless? What is God? What is God? What is God in Quran?
I've asked you a question and
who
you're,
is
not even, you're not even answering.
What do you mean I'm not answering? I'm giving you the answer.
I said to you, the only person who knows the hour is the Father, yes
right,
or no?
Right, yeah.
Right?
Right.
Now, you believe in a Trinity
right.
where it consists of three persons.
But they have roles.
Hold on 1 second.
Yes.
The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Is the Holy Spirit the Father?
No.
Right, they're separate beings, right?
The separate beings. One entity. Yes.
Good. Now, with that in mind, right, did the Holy Spirit know the Day of Judgment?
Did the Holy Spirit know the Day of Judgment? If he's communing with the Father, yes.
Well, Jesus said, no one knows the hour except God alone.
No one.
So is Jesus lying?
No one.
What does no one mean?
No one.
What does no one
him,
mean?
Him. No,
what
one.
Does no one mean?
No one.
No, but what does no one mean?
One. Not him. Not men. Men don't know.
If no one, then why is there three?
Only the Father.
Only
in heaven.
The Father in heaven.
Right.
So is Jesus separate from the Father?
Is Jesus separate from the Father?
Because at that point, if Jesus said to you, only the Father knows the hour. Right. So that excludes Jesus?
No, it doesn't. In your brain, it's... Okay, so when Jesus say, I lay down my life, and I pick it up again, so he can empty himself of knowledge and get that knowledge back.
Jesus said, the Son.
Right.
Who is the Son?
The Son of Man. That time, Jesus, in that point of moment, right, as Jesus incarnate in there, he chose to empty himself. Right.
So okay. So basically, what you're saying is that Jesus is a pathological liar.
No, that's what you're saying.
You are accusing of that. Thank you very much.
And you are accusing.
You have three Jesus under the bus.
And in judgment, you are going to have to face
it. Either I'm talking another language to you,
you must,
or
be.
You are not talking. Oh,
you
or
must be.
You don't understand.
Look, I got a recording. You brought up six different subjects.
Hold on 1 second. I don't mean that disrespectfully. But
I've
just shown you.
No, you ain't shown nothing. You ain't shown nothing.
Really?
I haven't. Nothing. So now let me ask you something. I ask you now?
Free.
When Jesus said,
when
Jesus said,
leave it.
I lay down my life. No, look, when Jesus, see how you don't want to listen. When Jesus said, I lay down my life and I take it back. So when Jesus chose to empty himself of that knowledge, right? He can empty himself of knowledge and he can empty himself of life itself and bring it back up. Right, so your understanding of Jesus is warped, and you are applying things that is in your mind, your 1 kilo brain, that is going to understand the God of the eternal God that created all time and space and matter. Your 1 kilo brain.
How does that make sense? You add it to the Bible.
You believe that God is all knowing for eternity.
He's all knowing, bro.
Right. So if God, for 1 minute, doesn't know something, is he still God?
No.
He's still God.
No.
I can show you in the Psalms. Let me show you in the Psalms. Because the Psalm says, I will forget your sins and remember them no more. How can God forget someone's sins and remember them no more?
You know what that means?
The Psalm says, no.
You know what that means?
Yeah, I will forget and remember them no more. And that's God speaking. So where'd you put that then?
Very easy.
Right, you're going to twist it now, yeah? So God can't forget something.
Do you want me to answer?
God can choose to
forget. Do you want me to answer?
No, but you just said, if God forgets something, 1 second, he's not God. So by your analogy, you are dismissing that psalm, where that psalm says, I will forget your sins from the far to the east, I will remember them no more.
Just forget it, man.
No more. Remember, he will remember them no more.
Okay. And that's implicit. That's implicit.
I know. He doesn't like any answer. Like, even the other guy I was speaking to, all he did was shout.
You just got refuted. Like you're going on that God.
Bro,
no, but he said, hold on. He said he's not God.
Okay.
And I showed him from the Psalms that God says that he will forget our sins.
Right.
And
first of all,
he will know.
Implicit. It's implicit.
You only have the English.
Let me show. Right. Let me find
it. Do you want a response or are you just getting excited?
No, I'm not getting excited. I'll show you.
Okay, you respond to
you. Oh, you're going to respond to God, yeah? You're going to respond to God because God, the scriptures are from God.
You're
responding to the scriptures, not me. Not my opinion. Your opinion. I don't. I bring scriptures. You put your opinion. Your little warped London time space, mine.
Okay.
Right? You want to understand the creator of the universe.
Okay.
Let me tell you the psalm. That God forgets your sins. Let me tell you the psalm. Psalm 103:12. Let's look it up now. Psalm 103:12.
forgets.
God never forgets, yeah?
That just refutes your belief. Okay. Because that just means you don't need someone to die for someone's sins. Yeah. Because God will simply forgive you your sins.
If God forgets, you said.
Last time I checked, I was still here.
God forgets for 1 minute. Yeah. He's not God. Let me show you he's God.
Okay.
Let me show
you. Okay. Why are you showing me? I will speak.
Speak your people. I won't make no sense.
Right, first of all, right. If you're going to show me that God forgets people,
oh, you know what to show you.
You see, okay, right. So if you're going to show me that God can actually forget sins, that means he actually forgives sins. That's what it shows.
He said forget.
What does fully
mean? Forget.
Forget.
Oh, so forget is the same as forgive.
So what does God imply?
So what does God imply? Are you changing the dictionary now to suit your Islamic view?
You changed the Bible.
My friend, I'm asking you a question.
You've got 18 Qurans, dear.
18
different Qurans.
My friend, I'm asking you a question. What are you implying when God says he forgets? What are you implying? If you're saying that God actually forgets, that's bad on you.
That's
bad on you.
Because I'm saying it.
Officer, arrest him. He's on crack.
Well, the Bible's been changed. That's my argument.
Oh, the Bible. So why did Muhammad confirm it and swore by it? Oh, so you don't know your own Quran? Let me show you the Psalm first, mate. Because you look jump, and that's your tactic.
You know, but
let
me show you the Psalm. My first point.
Well, I'm answering your first point. You said
about Jesus being with
claimed,
God.
No, you claim. You claimed if God forgets something for 1 minute, he's not God.
No, that's not the first point.
He claimed that.
His first point was.
Yeah, all right.
If Jesus was with God,
he's
on about the first.
No, his last point.
Where did you go from the left?
No, his last point. Now.
We're right. On about the first point.
His last point was that if God forgets for one minute, he's not God.
You're all over the place, man. Stay at one point, man.
I'm not all over the
place.
You are all over the place.
Do you want to stick? Do you want to talk about Jesus or do you want to talk about this point you're making?
Because every time I reply,
you just start
jumping.
I want
to show you that God can forget.
They like to debate about the Quran.
But that's even worse.
But it refutes him. It's your own Bible. It refutes you.
It doesn't refute.
It does. It does.
It shows God has the power to blot out.
If I show you. If I show you a contradiction in the Quran, you refuse
me.
No, it doesn't. It's your brain understanding that. So look at that. God can choose to forget.
So if I kill someone, then God will forget. Oh, did he do that? I'm
God
not sure.
Can block that sin.
Are you serious?
God can block that sin.
So, thank you. So yeah, now exactly. That's exactly the point I'm raising, right? So God has the ability to forgive sins. That's what he means by forgetting.
It says forget here. Forget.
This guy's saying God can black out, basically.
He can choose. He has the power. You don't, as a human being, right? If you have a bad experience, it will always be there and it will cause you mental
God was like Derek Chisora yesterday,
but God can choose to blow out.
If God, if I do something really bad, God would God forget what I did? Can he forget?
In the blood of Jesus Christ, yes.
So you can do any wrongdoing, yeah, and then God will forget what you did.
Any wrongdoing? Yeah. If you genuinely repent.
Why would you repent and genuinely Jesus repent for your sins?
Genuinely repent.
Your sins have been forgiven.
No, not if you don't know the Lord. Not if you're not in Christ. You can be sorry, oh, I killed this. But you're not in Christ.
So then, hold on. So Jesus died for whose sins?
For his people. His people's sins.
Are you his people?
I am his people.
Are you Jewish?
No, so that he can forget.
It's not DNA. It's not about DNA.
Jesus said, I was sent to the Jews.
Right? And what did he say to his disciples? Now go forth unto all nations and tribes.
Okay, well,
so are you denying that?
Well,
bit?
That's, no, but that's a
so why do you choose one bit and deny another bit?
Do you want me to respond or are you just looking for a show?
No, but seriously.
Let him talk. Let him talk.
Do you want me to respond?
Let him talk.
Let him answer that question.
Right. So Jesus said in Matthew 15, verse 24, he says, I was not sent except.
Yeah.
Yeah. Except only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Jesus commanded his disciples in John chapter 10, verse 21. Right. He says, do not go in unto the way of who?
The Gentiles.
Right. Are you a Gentile?
Until when?
Yes. Yeah. Until when?
There is no until.
What do you mean not until? So why did he say go forth unto all tribes and nations?
But hold on.
Of Israel.
Jesus said only.
Of Israel.
Are you blowing out what you want to blow?
Of Israel.
So you stop only. On one part. Listen, so you stop only.
Excuse me, what does only mean?
Well, only to the tribe of...
No, I'm asking you a question. What does the word only mean? If I said that this is
okay, what does the word... What does the word go unto all tribes and nations mean? What does that mean?
Look, you have to read the first bit of the sentence first, man.
What does that mean?
You need to answer that.
Yeah. What does it mean? Go unto all tribes and nations.
Right. Can you,
what does that mean?
Why didn't you answer my question?
No, what does that mean?
What does the word only mean?
It means only.
No, it means like something that is specific.
Only.
Right. So if you're going to bring a verse where it says go in unto the, all the tribes. This can have one or two meanings to it. It could either mean what you said, right? Go into the world. But then if that's the case, then it will contradict Matthew 10 verse 21. It would also contradict...
It doesn't contradict...
Can I finish?
Listen.
Let him finish.
Can I finish? Lord Jesus.
Can I finish?
Let him finish.
Finish.
Are you afraid?
I'm afraid. It's chronology.
So why is it every time I'm start talking...
Because you're talking nonsense. It's chronology. The correct...
Let him finish.
Let him finish. Let him finish.
You can memorize it like... Bah, bah, blanchi. Have you any more? It's not like that. The Quran, the Bible...
Let him finish.
Go on, finish. Go on. Yeah,
forget it, man.
You can't. You can't contend, bro.